I started writing at the age of 6. That is when I came up with my first story. Most people, for them, writing is an escape. For me, that's not the case. For me, writing is the real world, and everything else is the escape. Everything else is by the way.
Art is anything that makes me happy. It keeps me calm. It stops me from having a lot of fights because I just zone out when I start drawing.
Before I pen down the first words to a story or an article or a poem, I like to block out everything else. The chaos, the noise. I like to write in complete silence.
I remember as a child when we used to live in Chennai, my mom took art classes and she would drag me along and I had to sit outside and they had a swing, so I used to sit there and watch these people paint. One of the most difficult things for me was drawing human figures. So when I finally got the courage to draw them, I just closed my eyes and went for it.
Two of my dogs passed away within 10 days of each other during my exams. Lita died first. She was a princess among dogs. She ate with her mouth closed and sat cross-legged. And whenever you were crying, she would always run up to you and lick your tears away. And Mint, her daughter, was the complete opposite. She was brave and she loved to live. And then, about a month later, an idea started forming in the back of my mind. About how maybe, what if you could bring the dead back to life? What would happen then? And that's how the novel started coming up. And without me even realizing it, I was forming the idea in my head. And in 2 weeks, it was ready to be written.
Campus Diaries has definitely helped me improve my work. I'm nowhere next to perfect, but every time I log on, there's always a whole bunch of notifications, and most of them are comments about every post.
Campus Diaries is unique in the way that it connects people like us who are just stepping into the world where we're just learning about, you know, writing or making videos or stories.
I just made movies that moved me and I posted it and I just kind of left it at that. I didn't really think about it twice, but it got a lot of views and likes and comments and a lot of positive criticism.
It's a great forum for us to express ourselves, to tell our stories, to tell our points of view.
Because there's so much support, it leads me to be comfortable outside my comfort zone.
So it's an amazing exchange of ideas, and that's why I think Campus Diaries is so unique and so important and such a breakthrough.
Another project that I'm currently a part of is Project. It's about encouraging conversation about bras among Indian youth. You know, we're making videos and we have to research and do a lot more information-based articles and posts and drawings.
My next big step is writing the sequel to my novel. And the only way I can do that is if I get the silence, the calm, the peace and quiet that helps me get started.
People always ask me, what's the toughest part about drawing? In my opinion, it's knowing when to start, knowing where exactly that pencil needs to land on that paper and what to do with it next. And finally, knowing when it's done.